This is how to tram a milling machine. So tramming a milling machine is the alignment process of getting the spindle to be perfectly perpendicular to the table. There are two adjustments that we're going to make. One is rotation about the x-axis, so we'll call that the a-axis rotation. One is the rotation about the y-axis, and we'll call that the b-axis rotation. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that the machine is locked out and tagged out if you're working in a shop with other people around. Because when you tram the mill, you're going to put tooling into the spindle that's not designed to rotate. And bad things can happen if the mill gets switched on with a tramming tool, a spindle square, an indicator or something like that in the spindle. So it's a good idea just to lock out and tag out, at least to power off the machine at the source. Next, we're going to make sure that the machine is level. Always a good double check. If you know that the machine has been precision leveled, then you don't need to mess with this step. But if not, it's a good idea to double check. All right, then we're going to adjust the ram and the turret. Make sure that they're in the position where we're going to use them most often. If they're already in that location, you can just skip that step. Now, we want to make sure that we don't have anything heavy on the table. We want to take off the vise. If there's a vise on the table, we want to take anything like that. We want it to have anything heavy completely off the machine. You don't want to just slide it over to the side. That will deflect the table. We want to make sure that we have nothing on the table at all. Then we're going to center the table in the X and Y location. And I think it's a good idea to lightly clamp the table in that position. So just lightly apply the clamps. You want to clean the surface of the table. Make sure that there's no grime or grit on the table. And then you'll install the tool that you're going to tram with. So this can be a dedicated tramming tool like a spindle square, or it can be an Indicol, or any other type of indicator holder. All you really need is to be able to rotate an indicator around, to sweep an indicator around and measure different parts of the table, left and right and in and out. If you have a spindle square, that makes this a lot easier, but it's not necessary at all. All you need is something that can go into the spindle and that can be rotated and that is nice and rigid. So I used this boring head with a piece of drill rod in it and just clamped my indicator to another piece of drill rod. All right, I like to do this with the quill locked. Some people like to adjust with the quill, but either way works fine, but I like to go ahead and lock the quill gently. Then I want to put the spindle in neutral. Putting the spindle in neutral will allow you to spin the tram or your spindle square around easily, and it will stay in position. And now is the time, if you're using a spindle square, to go ahead and zero out the two indicator dials to make sure that they are both reading zero at the same level. You want to make sure that your indicators have about a half a turn to be where your zero is. All right, you don't want it to go around more than once, and you don't want the indicator dial to just start moving. You want to make sure that it's fully contacted and has about a half a rotation of movement. That's where you want your zero to be. Now, a couple of things to do before we loosen the nuts that hold the head in position, and that is to take off the fine feed hand wheel for the quill fine feed, and also to remove this feed direction control knob. The threads that hold this thing on are very, very tiny, and this is a good way to break that feed direction control knob off of your mill. Also, you can lower the knee and drop the table out of the way so that it's up, or so that the indicator's up and away from the table, because when you loosen the nuts that hold the head in position, it will sometimes tip a few degrees and it could damage your indicator. All right, now there are different schools of thought as to which axis you would want to indicate in first. I think it's easier to go ahead and just fix the worst axis first of all. So if you have one that's one, whether it's A or B rotation that is worse, I would worry about getting it brought into square first of all. So in this one, we're going to adjust the B axis rotation here. So this B swivel here, that is this rotation about the Y axis. So there are four binding nuts on here, these lock nuts that you will loosen. And so you go ahead and loosen these up until you can tell that they're loose. And this is the time when it's common for the head to kind of tilt a little bit. And then what I like to do is re-snug all of the nuts, not tightly, but to the same torque. So, you know, just a foot pound or two against each one so that you can tell that the head casting is secure, but you'll be able to force it into position with the worm gear. Then what I like to do is intentionally tilt the head out of whack. So tilt it in one direction or the other, just 3 or 4 degrees. And what you're going to try to do is work in one direction, because there's so much backlash in the worm gear that it's difficult to go back and forth. It's much easier to bring the head into square from one direction rather than trying to work back and forth. So I'll tip it over intentionally, and that lets you kind of feel which direction you need to be turning the worm gear to get the head moving towards square. All right, so whichever direction that you turned the worm gear to tilt the head out of position, you're going to turn it now in the opposite direction, and you're going to now begin to move your indicator into position. What I like to do is raise the knee, because I think that's kind of the most solid part of this. So I'll raise the knee up until it begins to touch the indicator. And the side that makes contact first is the low side. And what you'll need to do as you bring the head into square is to raise the knee up until it's contacting both of the indicators. And at that point, when it contacts both of them, you can start to split the difference between the two indicators and bring the head into square. And as you start to get close, when you start to get within like one or two thou, it's time to kind of start snugging everything down. So start snugging those lock nuts, get them a little bit tighter. Make sure that you're not moving anything out of square as you do that, and just kind of sneak up on those zeros. Now, when you adjust this, what we'll call A-axis rotation, you need to notice that you can't just split the difference of the indicator readings, because the head is rotating away from the center of those two indicators. So kind of get in your head, you know, understand how this head rotates before you start trying to make adjustments. Otherwise, you can find yourself just chasing numbers around that don't really mean anything. All right, and after you have gotten everything straight and square, it will be time to install your work holding. So time to sweep in your vise or your rotary table or whatever work holding that you're going to be using on the table. Now you want to make sure that you take out your spindle square or your indicator holder, whatever you're using in the spindle, before you take your lock and tag off. And you're ready to go.